forest Kunda. Very special.
my mother.
Thank you so much.
What's your name? Gown now, okay?
Hello.
And your gown? Yes. Your mandir name, what? Srimat ki? Srinath mandir. And your gown? Govinda kun.
Thank you.
learn the secret part of Govardhan. Katha Dauji Mandir means Balaram looking from this to Nandagaon, try to find Krishna.
Chandan Sarovar at Nandagaon.
This temple is called Katha Dauji. Lord Balaram trying to find out Krishna is dancing in the forest with this.
Chandan Sarovar.
In the Chandan Sarovar. This is crown of Balaram. This is the tail of Govardhan, punch to the end place. So full of Hanumabag. This is last punch or last part of Govardhan. You can see Govardhan finish this tail, this place. Near to Asarakun, it's near
come before Jayapur. On the way to go to Jayapur.
Temple, very beautiful temple. You can see how it's carved.
y después la deuda viene a bañarse acá atrás. Sí, ustedes pueden ver, observar, se está dando reverencias a la deuda. Reverencia a la deuda. Pidiendo la misericordia para avanzar espiritualmente. Ese es el, después de bañarse a la deuda, con agua sagrada del Ganga, Yamuna, Saraswati, muchos lugares, los ríos sagrados utilizan el dulce y diferentes productos para bañar la deuda. Y ahorita las personas, después de eso, llaman Charanamrita, el néctar, viene directamente de los pies del loto de la deuda. Entonces el Señor se le da un poquito a cada uno para poder purificarse. Es muy auspicioso tomar esa agua. Es un agua que bendice y ayuda a avanzar espiritualmente a cualquier persona que toma. Arriba en ese monte hay un templo que se llama Yeah. sin para proteger Radha Govinda. Ahí las ruinas están ahí, pueden mirarlo. Estamos arriba de un palacio, de un king. De ahí estamos tomando fotos. Solo los musulmanes no podían atacar Govinda allí, porque está muy murallado, fortificado, así que de acá mismo lo ven, donde venga, donde puedan atacarlos. Ahorita está muy antiguo, pero en 1590 fue construido toda esta ciudad. Gopinath Mandir. Purana Bhaktir Rastra. Purana Mandir. This is a Bibi Colony. Purana Bhaktir. So this is a gas products for making a gas food, and this is Gopinath. Ofrecen Gopinath. La candela que ofrece Bhakti.
Thank you. shocked. Krishna's not pleased. Krishna doesn't like this letter. How could it be? This is in Brihadbhagavatamrita, in the last part, I don't think it's published yet, where Gopakumar goes back to Godhead, goes to Goloka Vrindavan. So Gopakumar was there, he had just arrived, gone back to Godhead from the material world. And so he was sitting there, he saw Krishna spit out this letter and make this face like, this is horrible. And then Krishna threw him the letter. And now Gopakumar had the laddu, and he didn't know what to do. What am I meant to do? Apparently, this is horrible. This is horrible. What should I do? Should I throw it away? But I can't. Krishna just took a bite. So he thought, well, you know, what to do? He just took a bite himself. And he found it was the most incredible sweet he ever tasted. Just beautiful, truly manaha. Most incredible laddu he ever tasted. And he was wondering, why did Krishna not like it? Then you know, their mouths open like, wow, what's going on? And Krishna winked, you know, gave him a wink. Yeah, get the idea, right? It was just a joke. He was just playing a game with Srimati Radharani. So Sanatana Goswami describes that happened here in underground. And every day Krishna would go out with the cowherd boys after breakfast. They would go out the side and they'd gather together and the cows would come and then they'd be get ready to go and everyone would come, Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda, they'd all come and to say goodbye for the day. So they all say goodbye. And then Krishna, Balaram, the cowherd boys and cows, they start moving down the hill. Krishna would go about 10 meters. And Mother Yashoda would call out, Krishna, wait, stop. And Mother Yashoda would come running out. Krishna would stop. Mother Yashoda would check his clothes. Is your kurta on properly? Belt tied nicely, is your turban on, and Krishna's standing there being a good boy. You know, children know what it's like when the mother sort of, you know, really gets into things. So Krishna's just standing like a good boy. He says, all right, Mata, all right. We're going now. So Mother Yashoda just unwillingly, unhappily, she stepped back, all right, you go. So they turned around, walked another 10 meters. Then Mother Yashoda called out, Krishna, stop! She came running over, checked his jewelry, his necklace, his neck beads, yes, two strings, his earrings, his bangles, his megaphone. All his decorations, his peacock feathers, all right. And Krishna said, Mata, Mata, we have to go now, Mata. So she stepped back again. Krishna and the cowherd boys, they turned around and moved off again. Then Mother Yashoda called out, Krishna, stop! Came running after. Let me look in your lunchbox. Let me just see what's in your lunchbox. Looked in the lunchbox. Krishna has an ordinary sort of lunchbox, you know, as children have when they go to school like that. But Krishna's lunchbox is not an ordinary, it may look ordinary, but it's not. She opened the lunchbox. Inside were so many types of samosas in one lunchbox. Many, many, many types of kachoris also, and many, many types, sorry, without chutney, and many different pakoras. Oh, aloo pakora, gobi pakora, and paneer pakora, many types we've never heard of, and many types of sanjis, many, just little bits, but whole lots of sanjeevas, lots. And many puris, and paratas, and rotis, and rotlis, and I want to speak of the sweets. Rasgulla, rasgulai, ladu, and laddu, and burfi, and rubri, and sandesh, and son papri. They were all there in plentiful quantities. So Mother Yashoda was looking at Krishna and said, Mother, I have enough prasad, it's okay. So again, Mother Yashoda had to step back. And then Krishna moved, they moved another 10 meters. Then suddenly, Krishna, stop! Mother Yashoda came running. I've got a little extra prasad, some special preparations. So Krishna told us, finally they were almost down the bottom of the hill. And Krishna said, Mata, we have to go, Mata. We are going, Mata. And Mother Yashoda said, I'll come with you. I'll cook lunch out there. You can have a hot lunch. Then Balaram stepped in. Balaram said, Mata, we have our lunch boxes. We don't need a hot lunch. It's all right. Mata, we're going to herd the cows, Mata. You go back, you do your duties. We'll do our duty. We'll herd the cows. Mother Yashoda said, I know how to herd the cows. I'll herd the cows with you. Then Balaram said, Mata, one thing. We don't actually herd the cows. We just play. And the cows are so attached to Krishna, they just follow us wherever we go. So we don't do any cow herding. They just follow us. We just play, and you're too old. So that was it. That was it for Mother Yashoda. She couldn't say anything. So she had to come back. But Nanda Maharaj, he sent two servants to accompany the party. And when they went out to Tir Kadamba, just a kilometer or so out from the hill, make a report on what Krishna had done since he left here. And then when he made the report, he went running back. And when he got back, then the other servant came running back to make a report about what Krishna did since the first servant went running back. You see? And when he got back, then the first servant went back again. This is how it works here, you see. People are so attached to Krishna. As Lord Chaitanya said, Yugayitam imeshena shakshusha pravishayitam shunyayitam jagat sarva govinda virahena. So they're feeling like that. That even a nimesh means a fraction of a second, not even 5 seconds, but just a fraction of 1 second, yugaita. It seems like a yuga, or like 12 years or more. Seems so long in separation from Krishna. I remember one devotee was telling us about how he was there in 1966 at the first Janmashtami festival in ISKCON, the first for them. And Prabhupada said, okay, about 6 o'clock in the evening, said, okay, come into the temple now and we'll read about Krishna's appearance till midnight. Well, in the morning, Prabhupada said, we'll fast today. They had never fasted. So they thought, yeah, okay, we'll fast, no problem. By the time it got to this time, 6 o'clock, it was a problem. It was a real problem. They're feeling really hungry. So then Prabhupada closed the door. He wouldn't let anyone go out. And he read Srimad Bhagavatam 10th Canto in Sanskrit. And they were sitting there for like 5 or 6 hours waiting. And this devotee was telling me he was watching the clock. And he was second hand. It was going tick and stop. Then after a while, some time passed, then it went tick again. So it was like time stopped in separation. But they feel in separation from Krishna that one little tick, 1 second, is so long. It's too long. They can't tolerate. So pastimes like these happened here. There's another pastime we can tell you the beginnings of. That one time Lord Shiva came here to have darshan of Krishna. And he knocked on the door. Mother Yashoda opened the door. She didn't know it was Lord Shiva. She saw this man. He just looked. At Guru Puja, Guru Mukha Padma Vakya, Chite Te Kariya Aikya, Arna Koryo Mane Asha. My only desire is to have my mind purified by the words emanating from his lotus mouth. Padma Vakya. Asha. This is our desire. Ye Prasari Ore Sarva Asha. So we were explaining up there on top of the hill how Lord Shiva came and he wanted the darshan of Krishna, but Mother Yashoda was not willing. Yashoda first refused him, then Lord Shiva became disappointed and he came down here and he sat just under a tree, just over there where you ladies are sitting, and he sat there as he usually does. You know, he sits cross-legged in meditation with his beads with his eyes closed or half closed, and just chants the holy names of the Supreme Personality of Godhead and deeply meditates within on Krishna. So Lord Shiva, he did like that. He did that. And he was just praying and desiring that please let me have the darshan of Krishna. Please let me have that darshan. And then Mother Yashoda came. And all the gopis came. And then he got the darshan of Krishna. So we should desire. Prabhupada would say you have to deserve first before you can desire something very high. But first you have to have a desire, otherwise why would you try to deserve? So desire is a very important part of Krishna consciousness. And we know that Lord Shiva, he's known as Ashutosha. He satisfies people's desires. Of course, unfortunately, generally the Hindu people, the demigod worshippers, they worship Lord Shiva with all sorts of material desires, isn't it? You know, there's the famous song you all know, Om Jai Jagadisha Hare Maham. Yeah. But there's another verse. There's an extra verse which they didn't teach you. It goes, give me a house and a car and a color TV. Om Jai Jagadisha Hare. And a video player machine so I can watch Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. what people want. Most people, this is their desire. They want material things. And so we all know, at least those of you from Hindu backgrounds, you know so well that Lord Shiva is a very popular deity because he's famous for fulfilling people's desires quickly, because he's Ashutosh. He easily satisfies their desires. So why does he easily satisfy their desires? Why does he do that? Is it that Lord Shiva is just enthusiastic to see you get your new BMW? Or your new job with the new software company? Lord Shiva is really so interested in that? Well, I don't think he's really so interested in those things. Srila Prabhupada gave a very interesting description of why Lord Shiva is Ashutosh, why he fulfills people's material desires so easily and so quickly. Prabhupada said that Lord Shiva, he is sitting there, like we said, under the tree, sitting cross-legged, eyes closed, chanting on his Rudraksha Mala, deeply absorbed in meditating on the Lord and remembering Krishna. So that is what he likes to do. He's in ecstasy. He's in transcendental ecstasy, chanting the holy names. He doesn't care about a new Mercedes-Benz or anything like that. This is all rubbish to him. But then along comes you, not you, you're all devotees, but along comes you, the materialist, the demigod worshipper, right? Knocking on the door. Lord Shiva, here I am. Here's my shopping list. I will give you 100 rupees. I will give you 100 rupee donation. All I want is a new BMW. People think like that. I will go to the temple. I will take one banana and a 1/4 liter of milk. And after 3 months, I expect a new Mercedes-Benz. Anyway, the thing is, these people come to Lord Shiva, knocking on his door, please give me a new car, a new house, a new job, a new wife, a new whatever. Please give me all these things. There's Lord Shiva deep in meditation, chanting, absorbed, transcendently, and there's this fellow trying to get his attention. So Lord Shiva, you know, when he's disturbed like that, he comes out of his meditation. Then he sees there's this silly fool who wants all these material things. So Lord Shiva says, just take it and go. Just take your new car and just get out of here so I can get back to chanting the holy name and really get back to where I want to be. So this is why Lord Shiva is Ashutosh. Not because he's so keen that you get a new sari or, you know, something like that. No, he just does that because it's his duty. He knows Krishna's given him that duty, so he does it. But not that he wants to do it. He wants to hear and chant about Krishna. And that's what he does. So this is the place then of Asha Isha, Asheshra, Ashesha Mahadev, Lord Shiva, who was so deeply, strongly desiring to get darshan of Krishna, to see Krishna, to get the mercy of Krishna. Yeah, this is his place. You know, as you go around Vrindavan, you may see here and there that there are temples of Lord Shiva. You know, like a big, big temple of Krishna, little temple of Lord Shiva. So what is going on? Well, what is going on is that Lord Shiva is there as a devotee. He's there in the mood of the devotee. He wants to see that the service goes on for Krishna, that everything is fine for Krishna. He's not there to be worshipped as a demigod for material things. He's there as Dikpal, or like this, protecting Krishna, serving Krishna, making sure everything goes very nicely. So this is the Sheshavan, and very nice, peaceful little think perhaps we can just take a little water on our heads here, and then there's another just 200 meters to go, and we'll be in another very beautiful place where we'll stay for a while. Sri Yasheshavan Ki. Sri Yasheshavan Mahadev Ki. Hare Krishna. So take some water on your heads and then follow us.
Yeah. Maya.